Hi there and good day to you. I'm making this video to help people who want to study Jordan Peterson's work deeply, as I am in the process of doing. And the reason I'm making this video is because I spent a lot of time, perhaps too long, thinking about how I wanted to approach taking this deep study, because there's so much material to do. And in thinking about that for so long, I think I had some insights that might be of help to other people who are thinking of doing the same thing. So I will say a few words about who Jordan Peterson is for people who don't know, or for people who are still doubting about whether to go deeper into his work. So yeah, of course it's my personal take on it. I have my own background. I don't have higher studies. I haven't done higher studies. And so that's something to keep in mind while listening to this. And I will try to keep it concise and relevant, but I don't know if that will work as you might wish. So about Dr. Peterson, for the people who don't know, he's a professor of psychology at the University of Toronto, a researcher and clinical psychologist. He researches and theorizes in evolutionary clinical, personal and social psychology and neuroscience, and he has done a lot of research into history, especially totalitarian history, and then the link between that and the psychology of it. He takes a lot of interest in meaning in life, human development, the link between motivation, action and perception, story, psychoanalysis and analytical psychology, religion and ideology, history, as I said, consciousness and what we call reality, mystical and transformative experiences, wisdom, purpose, what we call good and evil, or what might be those things, and lots of other things. He likes to be pragmatic and motivational to help people to heal and to lead better lives, and how to figure that out for themselves, and to find peace in themselves and between each other. I won't tell you why you should study him. That you of course have to figure out for yourself. But if you're interested in learning about how people function, how we're alike and different, and how we can know that, and how people organize and live or may fail to live together, and be stable or may fail to be stable, etc. So if you want to learn more about that, then this might be of interest. So a little bit about how I arrived at the idea of these guides. The reason I'm telling this is because some people might have a different background and might need a different approach into his work. But so just so you know why I think like this, I'm telling you a little bit about that I learned about him when he became famous. And I was already interested in similar topics and philosophers or scientists. I immediately wanted to study his work deeply through his lectures, the accompanying readings thereto, and his book Maps of Meaning. So I thought all of it was really interesting. It really spoke to me. I felt like there was a lot to be learned there. I forgot what to say. So immediately I went to study deeply. Well, I Well, first, I took as I said, I perhaps took a bit too long thinking about how to do this exactly, because I don't have a background in psychology, for example, and so I would have a lot of difficulty understanding the statistics, for example, and understanding how to think about some of the ideas, for example, and so I first thought that I should study. Read all the accompanying papers to the lectures, which you can find online on YouTube. So I thought I should first read all these papers so I would get a deeper understanding of the lectures when I watched them, and then afterwards to go to the book. Then at a certain point, I sort of realized that, well, reading the papers was not getting far. It was quite difficult. Well, not all of them, but yeah, I don't know. It didn't keep my interest for some reason, I think. And I became too occupied with preparing for understanding very well what he was talking about. So I started reading other books and this and that, so that's why I took a long detour, and then eventually I thought, like, no, I'm just gonna take the classes first, which you can find on his YouTube channel, Jordan B. Peterson. So I took the lectures first of both Personality and Its Transformations and Maps of Meaning in the reverse order, first Maps of Meaning and then Personality. And I will say why I did it like that, and then I thought, like, afterwards I will do the readings, and this will so I will be already well prepared to understand what's in the papers, and how to connect all of these ideas together, and then move on to the book so as to draw it all together again, because it's a very fat book. Let me take it for a second. So this is the book, and it's written in quite a small font. So I just thought, like, let me do it like that, and then I think I'm gonna give you the reasons for why I would recommend people to do it like this if they want to take a deep study. And I think this because I think that it might be really the best way to really learn and grasp, well, like, grasp and remember the concepts that he talked about. So of course, it's not the same for everybody. Some people will have different amounts of knowledge and different interests. But I think for a full study, you kind of have to go through all of, like, most of the most relevant material that to what he's talking about and to his theory, let's say. And yeah, that is a lot. That is a lot of material. But yeah, if you find it worth it, then that's good for you. So I would recommend people to start with the lectures, then take the readings accompanying to accom that accompany the lectures. So I started with doing all the lectures, first of Maps of Meaning and then of Personality and Its Transformations. Then I went through all the readings, Maps of Meaning and Personality and Its Transformations. Well, not exactly, but I would recommend it that, roughly speaking, people would do it like this. And now I'm reading the book, and I am about 1/3, I think, the way. So I think that the classes give a simpler, give often give simpler explanations than in the book. Though, well, it's not exactly true, but the reason is when Jordan is in front of the class, he's trying to communicate as best as he can, and he has a lot of experience doing that. Like, this book was written once and brought out in 1999, I think. The reading, the lectures that he's been doing, like, even longer than that, I think. And so he really knows how to communicate these things by now. And so I think from many people, it will be easier to get a feel for the ideas when you watch the lectures. And yeah, the ideas aren't as exhaustively explained as they are in the book or in the even more so in the accompanying readings, the papers. But their essence is given, a lot of them are given, they're put in a context, there's extra material, there's practices, practices you can try, that all of this stuff he gives while during the lectures, and you won't get this in the papers or in the book. And I think that doing the lectures like this first is just gonna give you more of a better idea of like what he's really talking about, what he's trying to get at, and then it will be easier for you, I think, to, as it was for me, to well, a lot of the things you'll already have seen when you're reading the papers, and then some of the things will fill in details, some of the things you'll be prepared to think critically about, which are wrong, for example. And then at the same time, they will give you a lot of more food for thought, which might set you to rethink some of his ideas, etc. So I think that was a good way to do it for me, and it might be for other people. Yeah, I also think that the readings, the papers of Maps of Meaning lead a little bit better into those of personality. So the Maps of Meaning readings give more, I think, of a evolutionary perspective on like the foundations of our psychology in some sense, and then in personality that's deepened into like your personal psychology, kind of how that works and how people have personalities, and then even more details are filled in and stuff like that. So Maps of Meaning is, I think, more of a history, it gives more of the historical and mythological context that we live in, or talks more about that, focuses on narrative and its relation, focuses mostly on narrative and its relation to motivation, action, and perception. And there's a lot of evolutionary and clinical psychology and religion as well. Then in personality, I think the focus is more on personality and its relation to motivation, action, and perception. And there is more neuroscience, also clinical psychology, and more psychology than religion, I think. Then, yeah, as I talked about before, the readings, I think they will click better by then. Just you'll get the ideas will come easier to you. You'll already know a lot of the stuff. You will be able to fill in the details. I think you already might have a better way of being able to talk about them to other people, because it might be harder when you're just focusing on the more foundational science, while first learning about more of the practical way that like unfolds into your life or something. it gives a different perspective. I don't know. So that's another idea. And then, of course, book maps of meaning will. You will have to or be able to bring all of that together into a neat package again. So you'll have a lot of more knowledge to draw on, and new knowledge, and some like the theory that you've been learning can be filled in even more. You'll by then have been thinking about it a lot, and you might have some criticisms that might come up again, but that's good because you're learning to think. And then yeah, some criticisms that I have were that there's sometimes like an extreme amount of repetition in the lectures. Like, okay, maybe not extreme, but I just took some issue with that sometimes. But I feel like in some cases it was worth it because sometimes different explanations can make an idea click differently and better, for example, than just one explanation or whatever. I think that Dr. Peterson sometimes doesn't make very good distinctions between what is evidenced report versus conjectures or hypotheses. But I think that's understandable when you're thinking radically different in some respects, like he is. And then, on a more personal note, perhaps, I think he's a bit too serious and hostile at times, the way he talks, and especially in lectures, in the book, a bit less perhaps, or at the wrong moments. But I don't think he's a bad person at all. I think he has his reasons for why he talks like that sometimes, and I think he's open to debate those. But that's something. It wasn't too bad, so that's all right. And then yeah, what I learned or didn't so far, so a few points that I might mention are, I learned about mythological worldviews of various peoples, the connection of that with subjective experience of and existence in the world as human beings, like how we're in some sense motivated, like how we're in some sense motivated and self-realizing organisms, or motivated informing, I wrote there, but that's quite abstract. I feel like I learned some precise definitions, but perhaps more so poetic language to describe my experience. So yeah, I learned about I don't know, just psychoanalysis, I think, understanding a little bit like how people's unconscious works, operates, and how it influences their conscious, and then how to deal with that as a person, knowing that about yourself, and how you can cultivate like a more healthy relationship with yourself and the people around you, perhaps, by integrating even your darker sides and understanding yourself a little bit better and the other people and the differences between them. And the way language as well, the way you use words, the way you speak about your experiences, and the way you describe things to other people, etc., how that might trigger different understandings, and how being precise in your or more precise in your use of words, how that can sometimes substantially change the course of events or even a relationship. And I have noticed that, not to say that everything in my life has been going perfectly since then, but and neither should it, because some people really don't have their shit together, and and sometimes I don't, of course. But understanding that and knowing how to deal with that has helped me, I think. And so that's another thing that I learned. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it's been useful. I hope it hasn't been too long, but stay tuned if you wanna see more. I will be trying to make more videos in the future, and they will be about these ideas, drawing on Jordan Peterson, and I'm going to read a lot more of these things and try to, like understand the world in different ways. You can understand them and what that means for us as human beings, and how history has changed. Like, I'm gonna be reading a lot about those kind of things. So if you wanna know more, see more, stay tuned, and hopefully you will enjoy. So bye. Thanks for watching.